Hello. I'm Mark. I'm going to give you a quick demo of what to expect the first time you run Synapse. I'll show you how to set up the software so it knows what System 3 hardware you have, how it's configured, and what components you most often use in your experiments. The first time you run Synapse, the Rig Editor dialog will appear automatically. We'll use this dialog to tell the program about the connected hardware by building something called a rig tree. The fastest way to build this tree is by letting Synapse query your connected hardware automatically by pressing the detect button. Voila! Synapse has detected and inferred a rig tree that you can use as a starting point for defining your hardware. As you can see, Synapse found that I have a PC with a single RZ2 processor. Because the RZ2 is most often used for neural recording, a PZ5 was also included. Further, it found 4 DSPs within the RZ2, one of which was a DSPS. This type of DSP supports a connected RS4 data streamer. So the auto-detect also added this device. Synapse does a good job of accurately detecting most System 3 hardware. However, some device tweaking is often required. In this case, I'll adjust the setting for the PZ5 to match my actual connected hardware. When you click on a device in the rig tree, a corresponding dialog is displayed in this right-hand panel. Items within the dialog can then be reviewed and changed as needed. I have a PZ5 with 96 channels in my rig, so I'll adjust the device dialog to match. You might have noticed the check boxes within the device tree. These boxes tell Synapse which devices should be included in a default experiment. If you typically don't use a device, then leave it unchecked. The device will be available if needed, but not included by default each time you create a new experiment. When the rig tree accurately reflects the hardware you have in your system, simply press OK, and Synapse will create a blank default experiment with the hardware elements from our rig tree. When you exit the rig edit dialog, Synapse creates a rig definition file and saves it to disk. This file is automatically referenced whenever you create or load an experiment. You can see we now have a simplified and flattened version of our system hardware in something called the processing tree. Using this starting place, we're ready to begin building our experiment. But that's for another demo. More on the Synapse design screen and building an experiment in the next video. See you soon.